Have you ever been attracted to someone so much that your mouth went dry, you lost command of your English language or Hindi or Marathi, or you tripped over yourself and behaved like a complete idiot? That love just doesn't come from your heart, but it also comes from your brain. Dr. Helen Fisher at Rutgers had defined love into three different phases. One was lust, attraction, and the last was attachment. So does love make you lose sleep and drop your appetite? It can. It is all your brain working over your heart, mind over body, if you will. As a heart surgeon, I mended broken hearts all the time, but this is a different type of situation. Hey guys, Dr. Nene here. I practice as a cardiothoracic, vascular, and general surgeon, and I'm now a health tech innovator who wants to improve lifespans and lifestyles. So stay healthy, stay curious, and keep watching. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Aaj mein pyar kya hai, mein dekhta hai. Valentine's coming up, and so what we're trying to look at is the biology of love. And yes, as a heart surgeon, I mended broken hearts all the time, but this is a different type of situation in that the brain is actually dictating what you do and don't love. Helen Fisher at Rutgers had defined love into three different phases. One was lust, the next was attraction, and the last was attachment. And each of these was associated with areas in your brain and with certain hormones which would basically cause these to occur. Let's start with lust. It's all about the lovemaking, right? That's something that everyone understands, or maybe you don't. This is a G-rated show, of course. But the idea is simple, that it's something which is a biological process and it's driven by your sex hormones, testosterone and estrogen. Testosterone, across the board, will increase the libido, the sex drive. And if you think about it teleologically, it was so that you can procreate and create babies and proliferate the race. Estrogen, by that token, is an interesting hormone in that in females, during their ovulation, their drives may actually get increased. And in addition to that, their eggs are coming out. And so oftentimes with couples, if they're trying to get pregnant, it's usually driven by this type of hormonal imbalance. Now that's lust, but at the same time with lust, you get other things going on where you get dopamine. Now, dopamine brings us to the next thing, which is attraction. Have you ever been attracted to someone so much that your mouth went dry, you lost a command of your English language or Hindi or Marathi, or you tripped over yourself and behaved like a complete idiot? I don't think that's not the case for any one of you out there. But the idea is, in that situation, it's driven by a couple of other hormones, including dopamine, norepinephrine. And the interesting part with dopamine is, it's related to your central reward system in the hypothalamus and in a couple of other areas. And the idea is simple, that when it occurs, the dopamine actually goes up. Now it's interesting, with binge eating and with addictions, dopamine is actually thought to be one of the neurotransmitters associated with this, as it is with attraction. And if you were to PET scan someone and look at them under the PET scan, parts of your brain would light up with any of the three. So the interesting part is that's one part of the equation. The other part is norepinephrine. This is your fight or flight hormone, which occurs when you're under pressure. And when that attractive person across the way is walking across, you go into fight or flight mode, your mouth goes dry and various other things happen. And it basically also reduces your appetite and it makes you lose sleep. So does love make you lose sleep and drop your appetite? It can, actually. And then the final thing is, there is another hormone called serotonin, where the serotonin actually goes down. And serotonin is associated with a whole nother behavior for eating, appetite, and mood. And when it's high, you actually have no issues and you want to do all that. That actually is low in the way when dopamine is high during traction or during binge eating or during some of these other things. Now you would think the binge eating and lack of appetite don't go hand in hand, but it's a different type of behavior altogether. Finally, there is attachment, which is almost when you develop friendships, when you develop long-lasting relationships, when a baby cuddles with you, and that's mediated by something called oxytocin. And the oxytocin is what they call the cuddle hormone, which makes you want to cuddle and kind of someone or something is very cute and get attached to it. Now, the story sounds very simple, but it's not, because all of these hormones kind of interplay, and during the lust phase of it, you can have norepinephrine and dopamine surge, meaning your reward centers go off. And when they're imbalanced, bad things can happen. Similarly, with too much dopamine and oxytocin, you can have binge eating and major drug abuse. And it's been shown in many cases that if you are on cocaine, the dopaminergic areas of your brain light up in a very similar fashion. Finally, the interesting part, which I found, was that with other drugs like MDMA and GHB, they stimulate your oxytocin, and so they give you the feel-good impulses. And so while the story is not simple and all the neurotransmitters interplay, we're beginning to understand that love just doesn't come from your heart, but it also comes from your brain, and in specific from your pituitary and hypothalamus and the hormones that are secreted during each part of this. It makes you wonder that could you create love potion number 9 by using different types of neurotransmitters in an aerosolized fashion. But more importantly, as we start to understand what's happening, we could potentially treat illnesses like some of the issues that happen when you're heartbroken and whatnot, because you understand which neurotransmitters are lacking. And some of that actually is interesting in that we can potentially identify and modulate someone's behavior. So, not exactly what you wanted to hear about the romanticized edition of love, but the bottom line is, it is all your brain working over your heart, mind over body, if you will. But anyway, on this Valentine's Day, hope you enjoy time with your loved one and now have an understanding of what it is that makes you love, as well as lust and attraction and attachment. And there you have it.